over the last few months, Todoist has been kind of secretly tweaking and updating their Todoist Foundations update from last October. And something else I've discovered that they've been updating is their two-way synchronization with Google Calendar. And this week, what I wanted to do was to put together a video that would show you all the little updates that they've been doing, some of the additional things that you can now do between Todoist and Google Calendar, and just to see if you find these quite useful. Now, I should point out that I don't actually use this feature myself because I like to have hard edges between my to-do list manager and my calendar. But I know many of you guys out there do enjoy having your being able to see your to-dos with your calendar of events. So this week I thought I would put together a video that would show you how to put or to take advantage of all the new Todoist and Google Calendar synchronization. Now, before we go any further, if you do get any value from this video, I would be most grateful if you would hit that little like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Let me now take you into my demo account of Todoist and Google Calendar and show you how these two talk together to see if there might be something in there just for you. Okay, first up, I need to explain to you that you cannot do this from your desktop application. Neither can you do it from your mobile devices. You have to do this on the web. And I'll just show you this. If those of you don't believe me, let's just go into the settings, which is where we do this from. We go down to integrations down here, and you will see right here, sign in to Todoist web app to connect with Google Calendar. So don't try and do this from your application on your desktop. So let's go over to my Google Calendar here, but this is what I have. I'm just going to clean this up so you can see this is basically a setup for my Google Calendar. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to my Todoist. So we go to Todoist. Here we go. This is today in Todoist. What we're going to do is we're going to go to our settings here, right there. And we're going to go down to integrations, and you'll see that it's slightly different. So here we go. Enjoy a two-way sync between your scheduled Todoist tasks and your Google Calendar. Let's hit connect. Now, what this is going to do is this is going to get your Google Calendar and Todoist talking. So let's just hit that. So this is my demo account, both for my Todoist and Google. So let's hit on allow and let them talk. So hopefully that's all going to work out quite nicely. Now, this is where you get the interesting bit, and this is where you want to be a little bit careful. What I want to do is I want to create a new Todoist account. I don't want to put this in to any of my already established calendars. And there's a good reason for that is because I want the ability to turn this on and turn this off. I want it to sync all projects, or do I want to sync a specific project? I want to sync a specific project because I use time boxes. The only task that I'm going to have, which will actually have a date, is this week. Any other tasks that have a date will be way off into the future, so I don't need to see them right now. So I'm going to create, pick a project. But for those of you who don't use time boxes, then you probably want to change this to all projects. But for me, I prefer a specific project. And if you're time boxing, this is the way to do it. Set event duration. You can change this anywhere between 90 minutes and 15 minutes. I'm going to leave that at 60. Tasks without a due date should be synced as all day events, or you can set it up as not being synced. And that will keep your calendar obviously a lot cleaner. And finally, when a task is completed, you can leave it on Google Calendar or you can remove it from Google Calendar. Now, if you want a record of the task that you've completed, then I would suggest leave it on Google Calendar. That way you can see it. But for my example here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to remove it from Google Calendar. I don't want to see it once it's been done. That's my personal preference. Once you've done these settings, you can hit connect and that will all synchronize beautifully for you. So there you go. That's all you need to do to sync a calendar. Now, there is something else. What you can do is you can now sync additional calendars. This is a new feature. So let's say now that I've done that, but what I want to do is I want to select another calendar. Now you can keep this in Todoist. It would just create a new calendar for you. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put this as work. I'm going to sync only my specific project. So I'm going to sync only my purpose and objectives. Again, it's 60 minutes, should be synced as all day. Task review time should be synced as all day events. Okay, I'm going to do this only for timed tasks. Again, I'm going to leave it on, I'm going to leave this one on Google Calendar, and I'll just leave the label. So now I've got two calendars set up in my Todoist, in my Google Calendar. So that's all done there. Let's now go over to my Google Calendar. So let's go to the tab, Google Calendar. So now, as you can see, actually nothing's there at the moment. That's simply because I need to refresh this. So let's just go and refresh. I'm going to have to show the toolbar so we can refresh. I could reload it. There we go. So let's just refresh this, and you'll see some changes take place. Now, what you'll see immediately is that over here I have a new calendar. I have a new calendar called Todoist. That's right there, and that's all coming in. Now remember, I set up my purpose and objectives as a work task, and only for tasks that have got a date. So let's go into Todoist, and I'll show you how this would work. I'm going to go into my purpose and objectives. I've got a couple of ones here that have come up, purpose and objectives, and these are coming up, admin and coaching calls. Now these, remember, are two-way sync. So these are coming in because these are already in my Google Calendar. If you look here, my work calendar, admin and coaching calls are all set up. So they're coming into my purpose and objectives up here. If I remove these, they will stay on my calendar because I wanted them to stay on, so they're not being affected. So that's something that you want to keep in mind, how that works. Let's go back to the this week. So we got all these tasks down here. I'm going to go to today because all these are in for this week. Let's go back to my calendar. Now the thing is, all these are showing up here, and as you can see, it gets a bit messy when you've got it set up like this, which is why I suggested you create it as a separate calendar. So now I can turn it on and I can turn it off, and if I wanted to, I can change that to, say, red. I can change this to different colors. I think green would probably stand out a little bit more, so let's change that to green. And again, I can turn it on or I can turn it off and show it. Now let's go into my Todoist, because this is set up to remove the task. So if I just go in here now and I start checking these off, oh, what a wonderful day. All done. I've done it, all my tasks for the today. Obviously at the moment this is showing, but let's just do a refresh on this. And now you'll see that they have disappeared, and I've just got my task for tomorrow. So that's another way that you can do it. This is the way that you set things up in your calendar. That is all that you need to do. Now, if you want to change your mind, you can just go into your Todoist settings very easily. Go back into settings, go down to integrations, and you can customize. So this is the one that I set up for customize. So I could say sync to remove from Google Calendar. I could change that back to leave it on Google Calendar. Sync. I can change all these things if I wish. I don't want to change anything, but that's the way it goes. So okay, that's how you set everything up in your Google Calendar. It's a two-way sync. It's really nice. Now that you can actually add additional tasks and it's syncing two ways, you get to have a wonderful, you can set all your calendars up separately if you wish. I think you'd probably find that it gets a bit complicated when you do that, but there you go. That's how you can set up your Todoist and Google Calendar now for 2020. Hopefully you got some useful tips out of this. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you very much for watching this video. Now I have a question for you. Are you ready to go beyond the to-do list? Now, the reason I ask that question is because your to-do list is never going to do the work for you. Your to-do list is only ever going to show you what needs to be done. And that often can cause a lot of anxiety, a lot of stress, and a lot of overwhelm. What really helps you to get your work done, and what really helps you to become much more productive, is developing your own workflow. A workflow that you work from every single day that makes sure that you stay focused on the things that you have identified are the most important things to you. Now, that could be your work, it could be your goals, it could be your family, it could be your personal life, it could be your self-development. Whatever that is entirely personal to you. But the key is to develop the workflow so that you are consistently making small steps towards achieving the things that you want to achieve every single day. And that's why I have developed my Productivity Mastermind course, Creating Your Very Own Custom Workflow. And I would love for you to check out the course. The course is available now, details of which are in the notes below, and I would just love to see you in this course. So please join me in the Productivity Mastermind course, Developing Your Very Own Custom Workflow, because this is a course that's going to take you way beyond the to-do list so that you start to really move forward on the goals and the things that you have identified are important to you. Thank you very much.